It's time to check in with Doc Rob and the Concierge for Better Living. We take a real, raw, inside look at healthier living while sharing great ideas and improvements for a better quality of life. The Concierge for Better Living will help informed, intrigued, and interested listeners like you make better choices for yourselves and your loved ones. CannabisRadio.com proudly presents The Concierge for Better Living with your host, Doc Rob.
This is Doc Rob with your Concierge to Better Living on CannabisRadio.com. Excited as usual to be back with another wonderful episode. And this time I'm super psyched to have two guests, not just one. And we have Toma Kikas from CannaLife Science, the CMO, as well as former NFL superstar, New York Jet, Marvin Washington. We're really excited to have you both here. Marvin's an advisor to CannaLife on the sports side of things, of course. How are you guys doing today? Thanks so much for taking the time to be on my show.
Hey, Doc. Thanks for having me. Thanks very much, man. And anytime I get an opportunity to educate the public and tell them what we're doing at CannaLife Science, I relish the chance. And I just thank you for giving us and giving me this opportunity.
Really my pleasure. And you guys, I mean, we've crossed paths so many times in trade shows, and it's great they're using that notoriety and your resources to kind of get this message out. Toma, you know, give us a little background, if you don't mind, on CannaLife Science, you know, how you got involved in this industry and what is CannaLife up to these days?
Doc, thanks for having us. Well, we started CannaLife in 2010. And we wanted to get into understanding how medical cannabis works initially. And then we delved into the actual chemicals that compose the cannabis plant, which are the cannabinoids. With that in mind, we went after a license from the National Institutes of Health for patents called cannabinoids as antioxidants and neuroprotectants. And everything we've kind of done has been based on that patent and the basis of cannabinoids. So we wanted to build a socially responsible company that really looks at the plants and plant-based medicine as a new form of therapy for a lot of different diseases and ailments. So we are currently working on the R&D, research and development side of these pharmacological aspects of the plant, specifically one called cannabidiol or CBD. And that's something that we're really focused on in order to treat different brain diseases. So we're working on two different brain diseases right now. One that is a brain liver disease called hepatic encephalopathy, and another brain disease called chronic traumatic encephalopathy, or CTE, that derives from multiple head trauma, traumatic brain injuries, and concussions. And we're very fortunate, lucky to have Marvin as an amazing advocate for us and somebody who understands this from the inside out. And I'm going to pass the ball to him right now to talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, you know, I think that's really important. I'm glad to have Marvin on the call with us. It's one of those things that CTE that most people haven't even heard about. And yet, when I started diving into it, even as a doctor, we didn't get it. It wasn't a very popular terminology. I was more at first drawn into CannaLife based on the liver health. I think that there's a lot of benefits with CBD and other cannabinoids and liver health and alcoholism and, you know, certain, you know, we talk about in the cannabis industry, the Native Americans and how that could benefit them as well. And we know alcohol. But going back to the NFL, I mean, everything from Pop Warner on up, people are getting concussions, right, Marvin? And what are you guys finding in these? Obviously, with the professional level, you have, you know, you're a big guy. I stood next to you. You know, there's some major blows happening, and now we're looking at the repercussions now. And how does this fit into CBD and what CannaLife's doing?
Well, how it fits in is, and if you want to talk about CTE, which to me is, it's the NFL industrial disease, it's football industrial disease, because guys start getting concussions from Pop Warner, you go to, you know, junior high school, college, and then the NFL. And I think they get more, they have more impact and more traumatic at the NFL level because you have the biggest and the best. And this is something that Dr. Bennett Amalu, who's on our board, discovered over 10 years ago, and the first guy he discovered with was Mike Webster's brain. And the NFL gave him a lot of pushback on that, and they kind of said it was dementia pugilistic, and he told them, no, this is something totally different. It's something that is related to concussions and football players. And so when I met Tuma and Dean last summer, and they kind of told me about it, and then I met Dean, and he told me they had the patent from the NIH to research CBD because it has shown to have to be a neuroprotective and antioxidant for the brain. And I think that the NFL has to deal with this issue if they want to grow their game. I know everybody's talking about the concussion settlement, and it's called a concussion settlement, but CTE and the symptoms have been excluded out of that settlement. But I'm not deterred by that because I know if the NFL wants to grow the game, if the NFL wants to remain the number one sport in sports league in the world, they're going to have to do something about this issue. And I think we're sitting in a pretty good position to solve that problem, because everybody else from Boston University and even Dr. Malu, they're on the therapeutic side. We're trying to have a solution to this issue with the NFL for former players, current players, and even future players. And I'm excited about it. I'm enthused about it. And I look forward to seeing how this thing plays out over the next 3 or 4 years. But I think we're going to be a big player in that space as far as solving the NFL's industrial disease, which is CTE. And yes. I have a good friend of mine named Paul Fraze who's going through some of the symptoms of that now. And it's heartbreaking. And I just tell guys that when they see me on TV and they see some of the articles, they're always asking, you know, what's out there right now. And I just keep telling them, help is on the way. Help is on the way. And it is on the way. So I can't really go into what we're doing with the NFL, but the lines of communication have been open, and it's an educational process. And I look forward to not only the NFL being educated, but college football players and high school football players and anybody in contact sports.
That's great. I think that at first they wanted to sweep it under the rug, you know, as a once in a blue moon kind of situation. But from articles that I've read, the incidence or the occurrence of CTE in NFL players is almost 100% at the, you know, if you have a long standing career, it seems that anyone, you know, that's checked out afterwards or seems to have some effect here from these concussions. And if CBD and the work you guys are doing can make a difference, you know, that's amazing. I really do applaud what you're working on, and I'm sure all your fellow players, you know, the past, future, and present all appreciate that. We're going to take a quick break right now. This is Doc Rob, my guest Tuma Kikus, and Marvin Washington from Canna Life Science. We're on CannabisRadio.com, and we'll be back after this break.
The Concierge for Better Living will continue in a moment.
Gondrepreneur.com, your guide to the cannabis business world. Gondrepreneur.com is a comprehensive resource for cannabis professionals and entrepreneurs. Download the Gondrepreneur app on your smartphone or tablet to catch up on cannabis industry news, scroll through our daily job listings, and learn about successful cannabis companies, executives, and investors. Gondrepreneur.com, helping gondrepreneurs grow.
Educator, author, and advocate Dr. Mitch Earlywine is here to tackle the burning issues.
And I'm here to clear up the myths about cannabis and burn them away with science.
CannabisRadio.com presents a no-holds-barred platform that seeks to redefine and revolutionize the entire scope of the cannabis culture while opening the door for more to join the cannabis crusade.
Dr. Kevin Hill.
You can't ignore the fact that, like alcohol, most people who use don't have a problem, so I think that you need to think about policy in that way while educating people properly about marijuana. I think that's the way to go.
Burning Issues, only on CannabisRadio.com. Chronicling the latest cannabis industry news and headlines.
Well, with 4 states with tax and regulate and the District of Columbia.
The state of cannabis.
Oh my God, it's refreshing. We have people that generally wouldn't speak on behalf of cannabis for fear of retribution, fear of losing your practices, fear of many of those things, and find ourselves in a place that we finally can.
Bringing you fact-based news and views and keeping listeners on the pulse of what's happening in the industry today. The State of Cannabis. On demand anytime, only on CannabisRadio.com.
let's check back in with Doc Rob and the Concierge for Better Living, only on CannabisRadio.com.
And we're back once again. This is Doc Rob, your Concierge to Better Living on CannabisRadio.com. We have Toma Kikas from CannaLife Science, the CMO, as well as former NFL superstar, New York Jet, Marvin Washington.
Yeah, and I also wanted to be, I don't know how I can get that in, but, you know, Kenny Stabler, one of the iconic quarterbacks from the 70s, who should be in the Hall of Fame, passed away last week. And Kenny had some issues later on in life, behavioral issues that, you know, that his friends and family think he might have had, you know, CTE. And so he passed away, I think, of cancer, but his brain has been being donated. Dr. Bob Stein and Chris Nowinski at Boston University to study, because it's the symptoms of CTE that, you know, that lead to alcoholism, leads to lack of impulse control, leads to domestic violence, and the snake had all of those within the last 15 years of his life. And so his family and friends thought something was wrong with him, and that's why they donated his brain. So it's things like that that let me know that I'm involved with a good company and we're doing the right thing.
I
think.
And, you know, I read about Junior Seau too, which is one of the more publicly, you know, aware, you know, for the audience, for the consumers out there, they probably know Junior Seau's name and, you know, the news reports of committing suicide. And what I was told that he purposely didn't shoot himself or damage his brain because he wanted people to look at it. He said something's not right, you know, and he felt
exactly
in his own right that things weren't, he wasn't himself. And if that's something that these guys are firsthand saying, we need to do more research, I think that the scientists are starting to support that as well. I think we have no choice, or the NFL will have no choice, but to take the proper action, which is great.
They're going to have no choice. And I say, God forbid, but, you know, the deaths from CTE or suicide, they're going to keep coming. And the NFL cannot ignore this issue, because when you even look at youth participation in football over the last 5 years, it's down like 14%. So the NFL cannot keep going on this track, or youth participation cannot keep going down, because you won't have any players to fill the college ranks, which in turn fills the NFL rank.
Right.
People are seeing the NFL, it is. It's a dangerous collision sport.
Yeah, we don't want to go to touch football. It won't be the same. With the science stuff, I want to go back to Toma for a second. You know, the science of this is pretty interesting. And what you know, being that I've done pretty good studies on cannabidiol and other cannabinoids myself, I think one of the interesting things is it not only protective, but there's also the potential for repair and regeneration using CBD. And you agree with that? I mean, like, part of it is like, so you have, I got a call this morning that someone was in a bad car accident, had a bad traumatic brain injury. What do I recommend? You know, and my gut goes, I can't see how CBD would be bad for them. Now, obviously, they'd have to be in a state where they can get access it, or have a product that they can, you know, be able to get it and take it. And it's still preliminary, but, you know, you feel like this is where we're going. We can use this both as preventative as well as treating, you know, incidents after they've occurred, right?
Yeah, we're working on both preventative and as a treatment. Again, right now, a lot of the data needs to be tested. There's a lot of anecdotal data out there. So what we're doing is doing all the preliminary and preclinical work to make sure that, in fact, CBD does work in that way as a high-level neuroprotectant. It seems to be the case. Again, there needs to be a lot more research that proves that. So far, it has in a lot of our preclinical work. Again, anything that you take is good in moderation. So dosage is important, and, you know, and a lot of these other factors in being able to study how it works in neuroprotection, and then also the mechanism of action, which we're currently working on right now. You know, we know that in trials it stops seizures, because there have been clinical trials in patients. So when you have a chemical like this that comes from the cannabis and hemp plant that can have this kind of effect, you want to study it more. You want to know what the safety points are, what the efficacy is, but you also want to, you know, be able to say, okay, what is the dosage? How much should I take? you know, just like anything else, if you take an antibiotic, you're going to take it on a regimen. You're not going to take it every single day, right? So similar to a lot of other medicine, anything in moderation and in a prescribed kind of dosage is good when you know what that actually is. But again, more testing, more research. Now there's a new law that passed a few weeks ago, as you probably know, Doc, that allows more research to happen here in the United States, because we had a barrier for that for a really long time. Even though we have the NIH patent that's held by the U.S. government, and that our chief scientist has a Schedule I controlled substance license, it even took us months and months to be able to get CBD from the government to test it. So now that there's a lot of these barriers that have kind of been lifted because of the wave of, you know, how cannabis is being perceived in the U.S., you know, we're going to see a lot more research happen from companies like ourselves. And, you know, we've specifically focused on the brain because we think that's the next really big horizon in the 21st century. It's really understanding the brain that past hasn't really been able to happen. And to be able to do that with cannabinoids is really important. Now, CBD in particular works really well as an antioxidant and neuroprotectant, so it protects brain cells. And let me go into something a little deeper, which we've always talked about. CBD does not get you high. It's non-psychotropic. It doesn't have the euphoria or the high effect that THC does have. But, you know, there's different arguments about THC and CBD as combination therapeutics being good. Again, a lot of this needs to be tested. But in terms of it protecting the brain, we know that it does in fact do that. In the next year or so, we're hopefully going to be going into our IND with the FDA. So we'll be filing that shortly, and we'll be able to go into human clinical trials, which we'll be able to test how CBD works with patients who have hepatic encephalopathy, so the brain-liver connection. And then obviously CTE, which is for us, you know, a really important disease as well, because it not only affects, like Marvin said, NFL players, but it affects a lot of other contact sports players too. If you watch the World Cup, the Women's World Cup recently, in the semifinal game between the U.S. and Germany, there was a pretty big head collision. Now, I mean, who knows what happened there, and who knows what the effects are. But what we do know is that the highest rate of concussions in contact sports is middle school girls playing soccer, and it's because they report the incidents. So, you know, guys who play in the NFL, and Marvin will tell you, in the past, might not have even wanted to talk about having a concussion. Now the fact that all these policies have changed and people understand what the actual issue is, and that this can be a major issue going forward in one's life, and we always talk about this, and Marvin can address it. Quality of life is something really important. This is why we started this company, to be able to help a lot of people, help a lot of patients, you know, people with diseases who are in need. So, you know, this is something that you know, we want to do well, and we want to be socially responsible with. I think, you know, that's part of our larger mission. You know, the social responsibility of being able to deliver this, you know, these medicines to people who really need them.
Yeah, it's really, again, I know that's where you guys are at. That's why I was happy to have you on. And, you know, I've actually treated some clients or patients with CBD. I've seen seizures stop. I've seen the benefits of it firsthand. I'm so happy that the law is changing to open up more research, allowing more research on CBD. I mean, the government, and we can go on that after this break, but even the government has a patent on it, yet it's still a Schedule I drug, cannabis. And after the break, I'm going to talk about, you know, cannabis. If it was a constituent from any other plant or from a non-cannabis origin, would we have these debates be happening, or would we just have new products out there helping lots of people? Is the cannabis stigma slowing things down? I think that's really a big part of how the NFL is also reacting. So when we take a quick break, this is Doc Rob, CannabisRadio.com. This is Concierge for Better Living with my guest, Toma Kikas and Marvin Washington. And we'll be right back and wrap this up with some great information, and I'm super excited. Thanks, guys. Be right back.
The Concierge for Better Living will continue in a moment.
InternetMarketingNinjas.com is the online dojo of the highly trained and skilled Internet Marketing Ninjas. Disavow documents, reconsideration requests, Panda and Penguin penalties. Let our superior SEO ninjas confront all of your link-related issues. internet marketing ninjas are equipped to master any marketing exercise. Content creation, authorship, link building, PPC, and more. Plus, build more buzz for your brand with our social media marketing strategy. Discover all that the internet marketing ninjas can do for you. Visit the online dojo now at internetmarketingninjas.com.
Growing green to generate more green.
Hello to all you happy herbalizers, smiling trippy hippies, and everyone who believes in freedom and tolerance. This is The Grow Show, and I'm Kyle Cushman.
From food to fuel, from remedy to resource.
Welcome my guest, Ed Rosenthal, the guru of ganja. Let me ask you, right now I hear your lighter clicking. Are you smoking indoor, or are you smoking sun-grown?
What am I smoking? I'm smoking concentrate.
Way to get out of the answer there. So you're truly like the king, right? You just clap your hands and somebody brings you a bowl and you're all set, right?
I wish that were the case.
The Grow Show with Kyle Cushman, only on CannabisRadio.com.
Cannabis Confidential with Dr. Dina. Candid.
I want to give you the inside story.
Captivating.
I want to introduce you to my kind and amazingly talented friends.
Compelling.
We get to meet some of the most amazing cannabis activists and warriors around.
Listen in as medical marijuana pioneer Dr. Dina shares never-before-heard stories, chats with cannabis insiders and celebrity friends, and provides invaluable perspective and insight into one of the fastest-growing industries in the world.
I want to share with you what was once confidential information. Let's expose the truth, discuss the issues, and learn the facts.
Cannabis Confidential, only on CannabisRadio.com.
Let's check back in with Doc Rob and the Concierge for Better Living, only on CannabisRadio.com.
And we're back. And just to, you know, we were talking with Marvin Washington and Toma Kikas about concussions and, you know, brain injuries and how cannabinoids can really be beneficial here. And I just was watching the news about, you know, the NFL and certain suspensions, specifically, drug policy, you know, things. And I mean, cannabis is such a benign substance, even with a little psychoactive component to it. More and more studies are showing that it's less harmful than alcohol, obviously less than cigarettes, less harmful than opioids. And I see a lot of opioid use going down in areas where cannabis is being allowed, which is great because you have a lot of sports players getting addicted, and that's another whole issue, addicted on painkillers. And the liver damage that could cause. So, Marvin, I mean, I know you've been out of the league from a player standpoint, but from a consensus, like, I mean, where's cannabis fit here? I mean, I'm sure most of the players are not against it. I'm sure they see a lot worse things being offered to them or being as an option. You know, is that going to be a policy the NFL changes as a whole plant potentially, like letting cannabis be, you know, utilized? Or is this still an uphill battle that you don't see a light at the end of the tunnel for?
No. There's definitely light at the end of the tunnel. And I think because they've even moved on their drug policy at the level that you can test positive. Now, it's not at WADA's level, but it's moved last year. And I think this thing is going to keep evolving as society evolves, because you have a league where the majority of players are in their 20s, and recreationally, a great majority of their players smoke marijuana. Mm-hmm. Whether it's for, you know, whether it's to avoid the painkillers and the opiates that the NFL gives out like candy, or whether it's just to relieve the stress and relax, because it's very stressful, because your career can end in one play. But I think one of the things that's going to happen, and I'm hoping for, is that it's going to get rescheduled within the next, I don't know, maybe 12 to 24 months. And I'm hopeful that happens. But studies have shown that marijuana works well with painkillers. Hmm. And so I think over the next 10 years or 10 years from now, you're going to see, you know, I think it's going to be off the ban list of banned substances. And I think the NFL, through their research and what have you, this is something that they have to look at. You talk about alcohol, if you talk to any police officer or what have you, most domestic violence calls that they go on, they involve alcohol. But ask them how many involve marijuana.
So, Marvin, I know you just mentioned the you know, the science on the and the domestic violence aspect of it. But I just read an article that was simply about performance, simply about the use of alcohol the night before impacts performance, muscles, everything. And I think, and nothing else, from an NFL perspective, you want your players to perform optimally. And you don't see that detriment or degrading when it comes to using cannabis, but the actual impact of alcohol on muscle tissues and on the body, dehydration and so forth, is so more significant. I just, you know, I had to break stop you for a second, only because, like, to me that was like, it should not even be about, you know, one or the other. It's like, if you're a sport that you want the best performance from the best athletes in the world, you got to look at certain things. Now, I know they're not going to ban alcohol in the NFL. You know, well, that's not going to happen. But no, I think it's really important what you're saying, and I hope that the rescheduling does occur. I'd prefer it to be just legalized and then spend more money on mental health and support than prisons and arrest situations and court issues. And hopefully we'll see domestic violence goes down. We see opioid abuse and use go down. We see people getting proper treatment for mental health issues. And I think that this is something that, you know, this is a big picture. And I really hope that NFL, with your lead, sees this as an opportunity to, you know, carry that flag forward around the world. Other sports, I see soccer or football in other parts of the world following suit very quickly, you know, because they do have those concussions, like Thomas said, the women specifically. But I know all top level athletes. I had, you know, Brandon Vera, MMA fighter, talking about concussions and blows to the brain. I mean, you have so many areas where this could be benefit. I know CannaLife Science is going to make a major impact. I think it's, you know, again, you guys are doing some great work. I know sometimes it's frustrating going through all the loopholes and red tape, but from as a doctor, I applaud you guys. As a consumer, I applaud you guys. And as a fan, you know, of the sports that we have put so much behind, I think that we just got to protect the players and still keep the integrity of the game going, you know? So,
well, I think the NFL can definitely lead the way on that, because it has so much influence. When you have 117 million people watching their premier event, which is the Super Bowl, and a lot of other sports leagues would like to, you know, emulate and have that type of sway and influence, and the NFL can do it. But I think it's going to happen because you have some progressive owners that are coming into the league, and some of the old guard, is conservative guard, is you know, unfortunately or fortunately, dying out. I mean, you have guys like owner down in Jacksonville, who they're very interested in being progressive and the science and moving this game forward. And I think guys like him are going to move this deal forward. But,
awesome.
You know, but marijuana is not the issue with the NFL. It's the opiate. It's definitely the opiate.
Well, again, I appreciate you guys spending some time today being guests on my show. It was awesome. We have a lot more to talk about. We'll do this again sometime soon. I know CannaLife has a lot of great things in the works. Marvin, you keep doing what you're doing. Stay on that. I know you've been on Fox and ESPN. Keep spreading the word. We need to get it out there. Again, wish you guys all the best. Thanks again for your time. This is Doc Rob, your concierge for better living, CannaLife Science, Marvin Washington, Tomatikas. Yeah, we're doing this, getting the word out there. All the best in health and happiness.
The opinions expressed on this CannabisRadio.com program are those of the guests and hosts and do not necessarily reflect those of the staff and management of CannabisRadio.com. Any rebroadcast or redistribution without proper consent of CannabisRadio.com is prohibited.